and am enjoying actually sitting up here in the loft of one of their barns, and brings back a lot of childhood memories for me. My grandfather had a farm, and I remember going there, and when our cousins would come in and we'd visit, we'd play hide and seek, and of course a barn loft with some hay, and it's a great place to try to hide. And thinking about that, it makes me think about the disciples after Jesus rose from the dead. They were scared, they were still in hiding, and they were actually waiting for something really important. Because after Jesus had appeared to them and they knew he was alive, he told them that after he ascended back up into heaven, he was going to send his Holy Spirit. And in fact, right before he ascended up into heaven, he told them that they were to go back into the city of Jerusalem and they were to wait there until the promise of the Holy Spirit would come. And so they watched Jesus ascend up into heaven. And then after he did, angels appeared and said, "Why are you standing here looking up into heaven? Go and do what he said." So they headed back to Jerusalem and they found a place to hide again and to wait. And again, I think about this barn. It's got some hay in it, as you can see, but part of this loft is still waiting to be filled. And that's what the disciples were doing. They were waiting for that promise of the Holy Spirit. They were waiting to be filled with Christ's Holy Spirit. They didn't understand it all, but they just knew that Jesus had promised it. And so they waited. And after several days came, when they were gathered together in the place, and they were praying together, the scripture says that there came a sound like a mighty rushing wind, and then something that looked like tongues or columns of fire appeared over their heads, and they were filled with the presence and the power of the Holy Spirit. In fact, they were empowered in such a way that they began to have an ability that they didn't even realize at the time. They went down into the streets, they knew that God's Spirit was on them, and they wanted to tell people about Jesus because that's what Jesus had told them to do. The thing that was amazing is that they went down into the streets and they began to tell people about Jesus and what he had done and what he offers. They were speaking in languages that they hadn't even learned, but yet God was empowering them so that as they spoke, they were speaking in the language of all the different people who had gathered in Jerusalem at that time for the Feast of Pentecost. It was a Jewish holiday. God used that moment in time after they had waited for the promise of the power of the filling of Christ's Holy Spirit in them. After they waited, the promise came and they were able to go out and to carry out what Jesus wanted them to do. And the message of Jesus spread out from Jerusalem that day. And as people went back into their various locations and speaking their different languages, they carried the gospel message from there, and it spread from there literally to the entire world. Thinking about that, I think about the things that we wait on today. God's given us many promises in His Word, and sometimes He asks us to wait. But while we wait, we don't go into hiding. We work while we wait. And that brings me just to the final thing as I think about being here in this barn. These farmers, they are constantly working while they wait. They plant the seeds. They make sure that the fields are properly prepared, but they wait for the seed to mature. As a farmer has livestock, he waits, or she waits, for that livestock to mature to adulthood. But while they're waiting, they're working. And that's really what God wants us to do. As we wait upon His promises, He wants us to be filled with His Spirit, and He wants us to work for His kingdom. And so we're going to be talking about that in this series on the Holy Spirit and living the Holy Spirit life. It's an adventure, And really, you don't have to wait for it because he's here.